Game controls can make a huge impact on your game, either negatively or positively. We have played games that we wished had slightly different controls to enjoy them a little bit more. And some games are very simple, but their controls make them interesting, like arcade shoot 'em up games. So in this video, I will share with you a recent experience with a client. I helped improve the controls of his game, and I'll take you through the steps and process I took. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi everyone, my name is Omar Bofaki and welcome to my channel where I teach game development and sometimes I create short films, and in the last few years I mix games with films using real-time filmmaking. Today I'm excited to share a new video slash tutorial format where I will bring a real case from a client and take you through the steps and thinking process that I've been through. Recently I had a client reaching out seeking improvement for his game Cars Don't Stop. He needed some help with the controls. The game concept is really fun and interesting. It's crossing the road, but in first person. Trust me, it's very fun to play. He's planning on releasing the game on mobile and VR, including Apple Vision Pro. But he didn't release the mobile game because he wasn't really happy with the mobile controls and it just didn't click with him yet. The controls he had at the time were dragging one touch to look left and right and holding two touches to move forward. A good thing he did was limit the controls for simplicity. So no moving backward, no moving sideways, and no looking up and down. He asked for my consultation and I provided him with four different controls. If you need any consultation with Unity, you can book your free call now. Let's go through the different iterations one by one. Since the game is in first person and he's planning on releasing it on VR, the first idea that came to mind was using the gyroscope to look around when the phone is rotating as if it's a VR headset, and one touch to move forward. Sounds fun, interesting, and interactive, right? Well, that wasn't the case, unfortunately. The cons of this approach were, it's not practical as you have to rotate a lot to actually see both sides of the road, and you need to do that very fast. It's not very comfortable, you will have to be standing probably to easily rotate, and you will have to recenter the gyroscope based on the player's current forward direction. So, not so fun after all. After this, I noticed the two main challenges that we have to overcome. The rotation angle to see both sides of the road is bigger than expected, and we need more comfortable control so the player can play anywhere easily. That takes us to the second solution. To solve the first challenge, which was the rotation angle, we need to cover as much of the road as possible, and in the fastest way. I decided to have two fixed angles, left and right, and lurk between them based on a trigger. With this, we will solve the angle coverage and speed. Now it's time to set the trigger, which will look left and right, and it has to be comfortable. So this time I used the accelerometer, where tilting the phone will trigger the look switch. When we tilt to a certain angle, it will look right, forward, and left, and one touch to move forward. Here, we have a huge improvement in the comfortability and ease of controls. Tilting the phone is fun and easy, but still not that practical for playing longer times, and you will need to move your hands a lot to rotate the camera. Speaking about cameras, if you want to learn making cinematics for your game and don't know where to start, check out my Unity Filmmaking 101 course, where we will go through the basics all the way to creating two cinematic projects. The first 30 students will get 50% off, and even better, you can get access to the first 5 lessons for free. Check out the links in the description. And back to the controls. Now, let's try to use only the touches and no more hardware and hand movement controls. I split the screen into two. Touching the left side will look left, and touching the right side will obviously look right, and touching both sides will move the player forward. This is taking us there, but still not very easy, and you can get a little confused when playing. This took me to the last and best control, at least for me and the client. To make things much simpler and intuitive, I divided the screen into two sides again, but this time the left side is for moving forward. Touching it will move the player. The right side is for looking both ways. I used a simple logic where I calculated the delta of the touch movement in the x-axis, so you can easily switch between looking both ways easily and fast. These were the control iterations and thinking process. I'll leave a link in the description to test the game and enjoy it yourself. It's available on mobile and also as a WebGL. And again, if you need any help for consultation or guidance, book your free call now. This is Omar Bofaki. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.